again welcome to your Disney class. Dear students, this is your first class after your half yearly examination. In your today's Disney class, I'm going to teach you chapter 6, grouping of figures and figure matrix, given in page number 41 of your Disney book. In this chapter, you have to study about three types of questions. Type 1 question is all about, in these type of questions, you will analyze the given set of figures, numbers and classify them into group. Type 2 is identify the group of given figures. You have to identify the figure and then you have to group them in their categories. In type 3 questions, you have to find the number of groups of 2s, 3s, 4s and so on that could be formed from the given objects. So let us see question number 1. In children, you can see that I have drawn a box on the board. In this box, you can see many numbers such as 3, 6, 9, 21, 33, 44, 48, 51, 60 and a question mark. In this question, you have to fill the correct answer, the correct number of straight lines. In the second box also, you
will find rectangle, triangle, square, and again rectangle, parallelogram, triangle, here a pentagon. All these figures which are made up of straight lines. But so what will come in the place of question mark? If you will find, if you want to know the answer, you have to check the options. In option A, you will see that there is a circle or a oval shape. It means that which are made up of curved lines. So this will not be your answer. In option B, you can also see there is a curved line in that figure also. Only in option D, you will find that in option D, you will find the figures given in the in that box are made up of straight lines only. So your option will be your option D will be your answer, because in box 1 and box 2 the figures which are given inside these boxes are made up of only straight lines. So you have to choose the correct option, option D, in which all the figures are made up of straight lines. Let us see question number 3. Dear students, when you will see the question number 3, you will see that there are 9 boxes, out of which in 8 of the boxes you will find some figures. In each figure, you can see that there is a triangle, a circle, a triangle, a circle, a triangle, a circle, a triangle, a circle in each boxes. And what another thing is there? There is either two straight intersecting lines or two parallel lines or intersecting lines, straight lines. Two straight lines are there in each of the boxes. It is intersecting, it is parallel, it is also parallel straight line, it is parallel, it is intersecting straight lines. So what will come in this box, in this middle box in which question marks is there? You have to find such option in which you will get a triangle, a circle, or an intersecting lines or a parallel line. So when you will see or check option A, you will see that triangle is missing in option A. Again, in option B, you will not find any intersecting lines or straight lines. In option C, you will get a circle, a triangle, and an intersecting lines. It means that option C will come here in the place of question mark. So the answer for question number 3 is option C. Option C is the correct answer of question number 3. Let us see question number 4. Children, in question number 4, you can see that how many groups of 6 boys each can be formed from the girls given below. In question number 4, you can see that there are many girls in this standing in a queue. So you have, the question is asking about how many groups of 6 boys. 6 boys can be formed from the girls given below. But you can see that there are no boys in this line. There are only girls. So your answer will be 0. Your answer will be 0. That is option C. Option C, 0 is the correct answer for question number 4. Now question number 5. In question number 5, let us see in which group does number 25 belongs. There are certain groups given in question number 5, such as in option A, you can see in option A you can see 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, da da da. Again in option B you can see 4, 8, table 6, 12, 18, 24. Do you know table, children? Well, you will beside the table of 2, you will get 2, 2, 2 on the 2, 2, 2, 4, 2, 4, 2, 3, 6, 2, 4, 8. But the question is asking that 25 belongs to which group? 25 does not come in the table of 2. Here also in the table of 4, 4 was a 4, 4 is a 12, 4 is a 4 to the 8, 4 is a 12, 4 4 is a 16, 4 5 is a 20, 4 6 is a 24, 4 7 is a 28. You will not find 25 in the table of 4. In question number C, in table option number C, when you will write the table of 5, 5 is a 5, 5 2 is a 10, 5 3 is a 15, 5 4 is a 20, and 5 5 is a 25, you will get 25 in option C. That is, in the table of 5, you will get 25. So it belongs to the option C. The number 25 belongs to option C. That means, it means that the correct answer for question number 5 is option C. Option C is the correct answer for question number 5. Now children, let us see question number 6. In question number 6, you can see that in the group X box, this is group X box, you will find certain letters. You will find certain letters. All these letters, all these elements are mirror images of English alphabet. Because when you will correct them, you will find that this will be look like this. This is S, this is U, this will become Q, and this will become R. So all these elements are the mirror image of English alphabet. So you have to choose an element which is the mirror image of our English element, of our English alphabet. So let us check option A first. When you will paint it, it will form like this. This is not any English alphabet. This is already C, but it will look like this. And this one is, when you will fold this element, it will look like this. This is a mirror image. In the mirror, when you will see this, it will form a K. It means that K is an English alphabet. This is the mirror image of the alphabet, English alphabet K. So what will be your answer for question number 6? Your answer for question number 6 is option C. Option C is the correct answer for question number 6. Now children, let us see question number 7. In question number 7, you can see that which of the following figures belong to group X? You will see group X pictures. In group X figure, which is given in the right hand side of your book, you can see in this box there are certain figures in which similar kind of shapes are there, and the region where you will find the similar shape is formed is shaded. So you have to find the correct option in which similar shapes are made together and they are shaded. So in option A, you will see that none of the similar shape, you will not find any of the shape which is similar. In option B, you can see that two rhombus are intersecting each other and making a same kind of figure, and it is shaded also. So option B is the correct answer for question number 7. Now let's see question number 8. In question number 8, which of the following does not belong to group X? When you will see group X in question number 8, you will see that there are certain figures drawn inside the box. All figures consist of curved lines. All figures are made up of curved lines. But the question is asking about which one is does not belong to this group. In option A, there is a picture of ball in which you can see that it is made up of curved lines. In option B, one more figure is given inside it, which is made up of straight lines. It means it does not belong to this group, because in group X, the elements which you can see all are made up of curved lines. So which is, but the question is asking about the element which does not belong to this group. In option B, you can see that a cone is imbibed inside a circle which is made up of two straight lines. So your answer will be option B for question number 8. Okay children, so dear children, I hope that you will like this video and you will solve all these 8 questions at your home. Okay children, and so all of you now do all these sums in your copy or in your book, and we will meet again in our next video. Till then, keep learning and do take very good care of yourself. Thank you.